Greg Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're talking about architecture and the style of Portland and its buildings. We're here with Dan Hanico and Brian Libby. We talked about sort of low culture in terms of things that are kitschy or campy or so bad they're good or tacky. One thing that, for example, the Southeast Portland, which is where I live, has in abundance, and you can find this all throughout Portland, are dive bars, I guess, is the common term, but these places that I can sort of imagine Archie Bunker drinking. And there seems to be, it is as the Supreme Court once said about pornography, that you can't define it, but you know it when you see it, and you know a kind of authentic bar or tavern or restaurant or whatever you want, gathering place, whatever you want to call it, that has that sort of feel to it. What are the hallmarks of that? How do you spot it? How can you tell?
Well, the one that just jumps off to my mind is on Belmont, the Vern, which is basically, I don't know, it might have an actual name, but it was a sign that said tavern, and the first two letters are hit by a truck, so it's the Vern. And that, I think, is just a classic accidental piece of art right there. You go to the Vern, and people know where you're going.
It reminds me, actually, I'm sorry, Brian, seems like
I was just going to say, I think of darkness when I think of those classic dive bars, and that I think there was some kind of regulation that they actually could not have clear glass, maybe so little kids wouldn't look in the window and see what was happening. And so I remember in my hometown in McMinnville walking by these bars on Main Street, like the Blue Moon or the Westward Ho, and always having a sense of mystery about them because you couldn't even see inside. Whereas now, say you're building some kind of brew pub, that wouldn't be the case. It would be a lot more transparent and have that kind of storefront window feel. But I think there's an element of mystery that exists with these kind of dive bars because if you don't go inside them, you're not going to have a single idea of what's going on, and or unless you use your imagination, of course.
And so in your head, everything becomes a glorious speakeasy.
When in reality,
Ella Fitzgerald singing. When in reality,
it's some guy with a beer gut, smoking a cigarette.
It's a guy who's covered in mysterious scabs, just sort of saying, we don't have any, the video poker machine's broken. I'm sorry, pal, you'll have to
have some of these pretzels from the Carter administration.
Speaking of the Carter administration, I was going to ask which era is sort of, we talked about the 70s being a little bit underrepresented. Maybe that's not the case. What era is the most represented in terms of Portland architecture? Is it the 50s? Is it the 40s? Something else?
I would say the 40s and 50s are really big just simply because there was such a building boom that was happening after World War II. It's kind of like a stronger example of what we've been seeing in the last several years with the housing bubble. For example, you'll always kind of look at Portland and know that in the first decade of the 2000s or whatever you want to call this decade, that there will always be a lot of condos that came out of this period, a lot of high-rise condos in the Pearl District and South Waterfront. And I think we see the same thing with a lot of buildings in the 40s and 50s just because it was such a boom time. And sometimes it's economics more than style that determine how many buildings there are that get built.
And Dan, you are, as a chronicler of Portland's history, you have a visual representation on your blog that goes from the earliest photographs of the city up till through the 70s and beyond. What really was the in your opinion, the defining moment? What era was it when a style started to coalesce? Was it after the fire? Was it even before that?
Well, we're talking about various styles that are represented. One of the sadder things to me is the fact that during the motor age, so many parts of Portland and some of the oldest parts of Portland were taken out to make highways. And so that what we were talking about last week with the cast iron architecture of Portland, we had the largest, up to 1940, the largest existing cast iron downtown on the West Coast, definitely, and really only rivaled by New York's Lower East Side. And over the next 15 years, Harbor Drive, the loops that came off of Morrison Street, took out a huge portion of that downtown where there was once 200 buildings. Now there are only 20 from that era. But those 20 buildings really do look back at Portland's first emergence as a very special place.
And there was a lot of talk, I think, in the not too recent past about, again, I go back to the sort of Mad Men era, and it seems to me I read an article recently where they were talking about the 50s and the 60s and the sort of the respect that people have now for art and for styles that were maybe under appreciated at the time. how long do you think it will be before things that maybe now are considered not all that beautiful, that are considered kind of ugly, will sort of receive their due? I mean, is that just a matter of waiting for this generation to have kids who grow up and look back at it?
I think that's a big part of it, that sort of 50-year cycle or grandparents appreciating it. Yeah, I think the other thing to say about Portland is it's never been a city that has been known for individual buildings and individual works of architecture. Seattle is much more of a city that's gone the route of hiring famous architects to do kind of candy-like buildings, whereas Portland is kind of known for what architects would call the urban fabric, the collection of buildings and how they work together, and the experience of being a pedestrian and having a kind of European feel where it's not such an auto-dominated culture. And I think that's really what makes Portland special is, if you were to talk about it in terms of jewelry, instead of having kind of just a couple gemstones, we have more like a string of pearls.
It's a charm bracelet, obviously.
Sure.
When we come back, we will actually talk about Pagoda was obviously just knocked down at 39th and Sandy. We'll talk a bit about the removal of buildings and how it meshes with the sort of environmental ethos of Portland. You're watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay there. Back after this.